Thanks, Bob. I have two functions today, one of which is to introduce the panel, and then the other is to be moderator, referee, stimulator for the discussion afterwards. So let me get on to the first task, and we'll let the panel members have their say. Starting to my immediate right is Michael Greenstone, who's director of the Hamilton Project at Brookings. He's also the 3M Professor of Environmental Economics at MIT, a senior fellow at the Brookings Institution, co-director of the Climate Change, Environment, and Natural Resources Research Program of the International Growth Center, and a research associate at the National Bureau of Economic Research. You're a busy guy, right? He previously served as chief economist for the Council of Economic Advisors for the Obama administration. His research includes areas that range from environment and public finance to regulation of financial markets, labor and health economics. He's extensively studied environmental topics that include the economic impact of climate change, air quality, hazardous waste sites, and the relationship between the environment and well-being in developing countries. To Michael's right is another Michael, Michael Gratz, who's been a fellow of the Academy since 2004 and is professor of law at Columbia Law School. Before he came to Columbia about 3 years ago, he was at Yale for, I calculate, about 26 years, is that right? Where he was a professor of law there. And before Yale, he was at the University of Virginia and the University of Southern California. And to my interest, a professor of law and social sciences at Caltech. And not something one would have associated with Caltech in recent decades, in my opinion, a failing at the Institute, actually. And so it's interesting.
Being a provost at a place that has no law school is really terrific.
Yeah, right. Being a provost at a place that has no law school is probably also terrific, actually. Med schools, too. His most recent book is The End of Energy, The Unmaking of America's Environment, Security, and Independence, published last year by MIT Press. And he's published on energy policy, tax, international taxation, health policy, and social insurance issues. In the early 90s, he served several years as assistant to the Secretary and Special Counsel and Deputy Assistant Secretary for Tax Policy at Treasury. And he's been a Guggenheim Memorial Fellow and has gotten an award from Esquire magazine for courses and work in connection with the provision of shelter for the homeless. To Michael's right is David Kaniski, who's an assistant professor of public policy at Georgetown. And there his research focuses on American politics and public policy, emphasizing regulation, environmental politics and policy, state politics, and public opinion. He's been published in many scientific and policy journals and is co-author of the book Superfund's Future, What Will It Cost?, published by RFF Press about a decade ago. He's currently working on a book examining American perceptions of energy options and climate change, and on a large-scale project investigating racial and class disparities in the enforcement of environmental law. Before he came to Georgetown about 2 years ago, he was on the faculty of the Truman School, the University of Missouri, and he's also a research associate at Resources for the Future, and is currently chair of the Science, Technology, and Environmental Politics section of the American Political Science Association. Cassia Yanasek is the next person down the line. She is entrepreneur in residence at Stanford's Steyer Taylor Center for Energy Policy and Finance and the founder of Tana Energy Capital. She has over a decade of corporate and private equity investment experience in energy with expertise that spans energy technology, power and infrastructure in refining and marketing. She's also a principal at the private equity firm Quadrant Management. Beyond her investment activities, she frequently writes and speaks on the topic of energy technology and commercialization and finance. Before present positions, she was vice president, member of the senior investment team for Hudson Clean Energy Partners, a strategy manager at BP PLC, and a financial analyst at Bechtel Enterprises. She is a term member of the Council on Foreign Relations. And then finally, Bob has already had a chance at the podium. Bob's been a fellow of the Academy since 2010, is a visiting scholar and senior fellow emeritus at Resources for the Future. He served as director of the National Museum of Natural History. Bob, I can think of not many more things that would be as fun as running a museum. That must have been a great gig. He was president of Resources for the Future, probably also a lot of fun. Maybe not sometimes, I don't know. And deputy administrator of both the EPA and IRDA. He served as vice chair of the Board of Energy and Environmental Systems for the NRC and on several NRC committees, including America's Energy Future and America's Climate Choices, and he's a national associate of the National Academies. So that introduces our panel, and with that, I'll turn it over to Michael.